Hello everybody, welcome back to another video, and today we'll be talking about the future. Well, the future of the channel, not 2036 or anything like that. So today we're going from, I'm really gonna butcher this name, but Debrecen to Verona. And today we're only going to be going to this first checkpoint, so I have checkpoints set out about every 20 minute drive or so, so then it's not too long, but we have enough to talk about in this section, the future. And comment down below what you want me to talk about in this section here. And again, this part here and the final part as well, and I will choose the one I think that is the best for this one and again the final one. So let's get back into the truck. This is a Scania RJL. We have a articulated trailer with 33 tons of beverages. We are expected to be at Verona on Thursday, 8:27 a.m. and Thursday, 3:07 p.m. and we should get €54,402 if we don't get any damage on the truck, and we have 30 hours 19 minutes left. So let's just set up the truck, turn the ignition on, put it in gear. So we'll just get on the road and then I'll start talking about the future of the channel. By the way, these aren't my skid marks on the floor, they're not my tire marks. So obviously somebody locked their trailer up. So just stop here. So the first thing we are going to talk about is the changes that have happened on my channel from basically from the start until now. So everything that's changed over a few months. And the first one is screen recorders. I have changed my screen recorder four times if you count this one. But the first one I used was a PowerSoft screen recorder, which came with its own editing software and all that. But I didn't really want to spend €79 to have it for a lifetime when I could buy Action for €45 and it's a lot better. But then I could download OBS, which I am running this on now, for free and all that. But I do like Action because I can I have a thing that you guys can't see, but it tells me if I'm recording or not. So that's helpful. And OBS just doesn't have that. So they're the screen recorders that I have used. And then the next one is controls. So I have gone from using keyboard and mouse to using a T-Racer steering wheel, and it's not the most expensive, but I am hoping to some point in the future be able to get a Logitech G27, which is force feedback and everything else. This one has vibrations, but it isn't as good as a force feedback one, but I didn't have €300 to spend on a steering wheel and all that. And the next one that I am planning on getting, which kind of loops in with the games, is a yoke, which, for those who don't know, which is kind of a joystick controlling mechanism for a aircraft like the Boeing 747, the Cessnas, and some of the old Airbus, and mostly older planes. They now have the side stick joystick, which you can get, but the yoke feels better. But that wouldn't mean I would only fly planes with a yoke in them. So there would be a lot of varieties, and that brings us into the games that I am planning on getting. So the first one is X-Plane 11, and after that I am planning on basically getting all of my wishlist on Steam and all that, which is a good €200 worth of games and all that. So once that's done, maybe in a few years, when I am a bit older, I am hoping to play DOJ RP with Polecat, Spears and Bugs. And if you don't know what that is, it's basically real life RP of Grand Theft Auto and all that. And I am planning on getting Wreckfest and some of the newer games and all that, but at the moment I don't really have much money, so I can't get all the games that I want. And that brings us into finance. At the moment, nothing has changed with finance, but in the future, I'm hoping if we gain enough subscribers, that we can get a bit of money, get a bit more games, do a few giveaways, and get a few more controllers and steering wheels and other things that you'd need to basically make it more realistic in for me and also for the viewer, because it's a lot harder to fly a aircraft with keyboard and mouse than it is with a controller or a yoke. So if you had a yoke, it would be a lot easier to fly than a keyboard or anything like that, which I only have a steering wheel, so I'm keeping with the driving games at the moment. But once I get the yoke, I will be saving up for X-Plane. I might do a bit of DCS World, which is a fighter pilot simulator and all that. And basically slowly get up to what I want the channel, what I wanted the channel to be when I started YouTube. And when I started YouTube, I wanted to give entertainment, and it wasn't for the money, which at the moment I earn nothing. It's only when you hit 1,000 and 1,000,000 when you start to bring in the money. So if we could get up to 1,000,000 subscribers, we could get better controls. By that I mean like yoke and steering wheels and all that. And we could get better PCs so I could play bigger games. At the moment I have a Intel 5 processor, which is a 2500. It isn't the biggest, but it's not the smallest, I don't think. I have a Nvidia 1050 graphics card and a 8GB of RAM, so I am planning on upgrading the RAM to 16 and then upgrading that to 32, and I've seen RAM for 64GB of RAM, which if I was building a PC which was like overkill, then I'd probably put that in it, plus maybe an i9 7500 processor, so that'll be good, and a 1080 Ti graphics card. And for those people that don't have a PC, I would suggest selling your console and getting a PC, because PCs are a lot better. You can get many games just quicker than you can on Xbox or PlayStation or whatever. So it is definitely worth getting a PC, and you can also upgrade it and customize it to however you like, and you can do a lot more with it. You could do your homework on it, sorry, because you have Google and all that, and you have the whole of the internet. You can download games that are only for PC and only ever will be for PC. Like, if you're into simulators, PC is the best for you, because otherwise console doesn't have pretty much any simulators. Is this guy letting me go? I'm going anyway. So yeah, console doesn't really have any simulators, so if you're into the simulators and big PC rigs and all that, definitely get a PC. So that's the PCs and all that. But for the giveaways, if I can get partnered with some company like Logitech or Asus, then I would be able to do really good giveaways of keyboards and even a curved screen, a curved screen monitors, all of that, and basically give back to you guys who have subscribed. And if we can get there quicker, that would really help me out, because then we can get the giveaways quicker and we can get all of this stuff quicker, get better games. And at the moment I am only doing simulators, but in the future I might do a few of the other games that aren't as fully realistic like simulators are. Like, I know me sitting on a chair that doesn't really move and just using my hands to steer a wheel which is connected to what I'm seeing isn't a full-on simulator, but you never know. If I get a lot of money, and I mean like 10 grand, then I would be able to get a fully functioning driving rig, which would mean 3 monitors, chairs and all that that move, force feedback wheels, height shifters, and all that. Need to move forward, I can't see the light. And all that. So, if we could get there quicker by everybody just subscribing, helping me out a lot, then that would help me, and in the long term it would help you guys just get the giveaways. And if we do get a few subscribers, then I will be doing quite a few giveaways, as much as I can, and I might be able to do newer games, like games that just come out and all that. And like I said, I joined YouTube to give back and to just help out with school. If you stress for school, you can just come and watch a video on my channel, and I'm hoping that I could just help someone and give someone entertainment, and that's basically what I was going for, and that's still what I'm going for. But financially, I do need a bit of money so that I can do all this and do it better, because right now I don't edit, and everybody knows that if you've watched one of my videos, and you're watching this one, so you obviously have. So if you want to see better quality videos, just subscribe and help the channel grow until we get the amount of subscribers where we can just do whatever we really want to with the simulators or other games, and like get bigger PC upgrades and get better equipment, headphones, microphones and all that. And I am aware that there is a bit of static with the microphone that I'm using. I am using a cheap headset which doesn't have the best microphone, but if we could get a few more subscribers, I might be able to afford just to get a proper mic. So that would be a lot better than what we have now. And another thing is privacy, because my parents like to walk in all the time. Like, I did an hour and a half video a few days ago of customizing this truck. Yes, it took an hour and a half. And right at the end, they came in, and because I don't have any editing software, I couldn't really edit that out, so I just had to get rid of the whole video, because it was like 50 gigabytes, so I was like, no, that's not staying on my computer until I get a editing software, which could be a while, or if the channel flops, then I might never get one, and then it's just a lot of space wasted. I might forget about it, and then see it in like 5 years time and be like, so that's why I can't download this game. So there is a lot of reasons why not every video goes out, but I am working on it. So thank you guys for watching, and if you have enjoyed this video, please leave a like and comment, and don't forget to leave a comment of what you would like me to talk about in the next video. Well, the next part of this. I'm not 100% sure if it's going to be Euro Truck, this Euro Truck, or not. But thank you guys for watching. See you guys in the next video.